Hi, I am going to give seminar over RSA algorithm, which is for the advanced algorithm subject, and this is guided by Ramana Murthy Sivan sir. So in this we are going to talk about the private key cryptography and public key cryptography, public key characteristics, public key crypto systems, public key applications, digital signature, signature of public key schemes, and the RSA crypto systems. So first of all, we need to know about that what is private key cryptography and why we use. So why we use means if we go back and if we check that in the traditional private secrets, it's private secret or single key cryptography uses one key shared by both sender and receiver. Okay, if this key is disclosed, communications are compromised also in symmetric. So parities are equal, hence does not protect the sender from the receiving for forging a message and claiming to send by the system. If we go in older crypto systems, cryptography, we cannot stop. It is better than that previous things. Like we are having more security. We can go for that less forging. We cannot sender can clear get the protected whatever the data he is going to send. So. Basically, we are using two things, two type of cryptography under this RSA algorithm. So one, we have seen that private key cryptography, and now we need that public key cryptography. So probably most significant advance in our 3000 years history of cryptography uses two keys, public and private, as we said just now. So asymmetric, since parities are not equal, and uses a clever application of number theoretic concepts to the function. So complements rather than replaces private key cryptography. So the public key two key asymmetric cryptography involves the use of two keys. Just now we said, like in RSA algorithm, we have these two cryptography, public key, which may be known by the anybody and can be used for encrypt messages and verify signatures. A private key known only to the recipient, used to decrypt messages and sign, create signatures asymmetric, because those who encrypt messages or verify signatures cannot decrypt messages or create signatures. So just now what we know means we are using two keys, as one is public key, one is private key. So as we will have, means public key will be known to the everyone, and with the encryption we'll use this public key and we'll send it to the sender, and later they will use the private key and they will try they will decrypt it. So this is the scheme that how we are going to use this, and how this public key encryption is going on. So just we can see here, like we have a input and we have a encryption algorithm that is RSA. It is this is a part of RSA which is going to encrypt it, and see here we have one. This is a public key for the this box ring, and we are encrypting it, and we are encrypting with RSA algorithm, and we are transmitting it to the receiver side. There it will be received by the Elish, and they will decrypt it by using that his private key, and they will get that whatever we have sent, it will be transmitted to them. So developed to the address, two key issues. So we have two keys issues, like key distribution and digital signatures. So how to the key distribution says that how to have secure communication in general without having a trust KDC with your key. And the digital signature is for saying that how to verify a message comes intact from the claimed sender.
Digital signatures, that just now I, as per it has given here, like how to verify a message comes intact from the claimed sender. So even we can tell in such a way, like digital signatures, like whatever the message we are receiving, I mean receiver is receiving from the sender, that is gone through that channel, that where it may be the theft by the other person. Just now we seen here, like in the transmitted clip text, that ciphertext, it is being transmitted, and here in between, like during the transmission, it might get theft. So in the since it has been encrypted with the RS algorithm, it is using a better algorithm. That so the transmission channel, what we have means where it we have the chances of that data might be the theft. So with that RSA algorithm, we have a means better algorithm, that whatever the existing earlier, it is encrypting with the use of that public key and private key cryptogism, means technique, cryptography techniques. So we have a less chances of data might be theft. As per now, we can say like we do not have the chance of being means data to be theft. Might be that I don't know, it might be the based on that channel, it might may loss, but the chances of being theft is we can say very minor. So coming to this public key algorithm rely on two keys with the characteristic that it use. So computationally infeasible to find decryption key knowing only algorithm, and encryption key computationally easy to encrypt or decrypt messages. When the relevant encrypt and decrypt key is known either to the two related keys, can be used for the encryption with the other used for the decryption in some schemes. Like it is saying, like we have our two keys, like private key and public key. So one we are using for encryption, and in the same way, like both we are using for encryption and decryption. So either that if the public key is known to if the person who is going to thief it, even they are knowing the public key, so they will not be aware about the private key, so they will not be able to extract the data from that encrypted file. So this is the we can see, like this is we have a source where encryption is going to be done, and this is the destination where data is extracting from the encrypted file. So see, this is a message source, and this is encryption algorithm, that is RSA, and it is like this message is being passed through this encryption algorithm, and then again it is being passed to this before going to we are having, like one is private key and public key, one is so it is being encrypted by in two terms. And in the same way, if we have means here, if we encrypt with private key first, so and then it is a public key, then again it will in the same manner it will be decrypted, like it will be used that public key for decrypting first, then we'll use the private key and we'll get the message in the same format what we had. So can classify usage into three categories, that encryption decryption that provides secrecy, and digital signatures provide authentications, and key exchange of session keys. So some algorithms are all suitable for all uses, other are specific to one. So see, we have means in if we talk about the communication or about that digital signature that have a communication channel, means the major thing is like data might be theft into the communication channel. So let we have an example like Elish and Bob. So he is creating signature and he is verifying the signature. And if the signature is being, if the signature got verified, then only it will be accepted and the message will be decrypted. So as Alice computes her digital signature as sigma for the message M using the secret key SA, and the equation is equal to SA into M. Alice sent the message or signature pair that M sigma to the Bob. When the Bob receive M sigma, he can verify that it is originated from the Alice by using Alice public key to verify the equations. M equal to PA means public key of public key sigma. So we presumably M contains Alice name. So Bob knows whose public key to use. So he is already having the means a list of public keys of having whoever can send the message to him. So once he come to know about that this message is from the Alice, he can use the public key of the Alice, whatever the public key is there for the Alice, to decrypt the first stage of the message. Then if the equation holds, then the Bob concludes that message M was accurately signed. So if equation fails to hold, Bob concludes either that the message M or the digital signature was corrupted during the transmission, or that the pair is not correct. So digital signature provides both authentication to the signer's identity and the authentication to the content of the signed message. It is analogous to a handwritten signature at the end of a written document. A digital signature must be verifiable by anyone who has access to the signer's public key. A signed message can be verified by one party and then passed to the other parties, who can also verify the signature. A signed message is not necessarily encrypted. The message can be clear and not protected for disclosure. Like security for the public schemes, like private key schemes, brute force, exhaustive search, attack is always theoretically possible, but keys used are too large, like it is greater than 512 bits. So security relies on a large enough difference is in difficulty between easy encryption or decryption or hard crypt analysis problems. So more generally, the hard problem is known. It's just made too hard to do in practice. Requires the use of very large numbers. Hence, is slow compared to private key schemes. The RSA crypto systems. In the RSA public key crypto system, a participant creates his or her public and secret keys with the following procedure. So select at random two large prime numbers, like is P and Q, such that PQ, the prime such that the PQ, the prime P and Q might be, say that 1024 bit each. So these two are the prime numbers, and these two prime numbers is not equal. It should not be equal, and it is chosen randomly. And we are saying like we are choosing a large prime number. That means it is not a smaller. Like we cannot factorize it easily if we calculate the multiplication of these two. So we cannot find out like which two prime numbers has been multiplied very easily. So we are computing n, that is the product of PQ. Then we are selecting a small odd integer e that is relatively prime to n. So whatever the value we have calculated for n, that in we for specific to that value, we are saying that we are choosing one another small odd integer e that that is relatively prime to n, and which by equation p minus 1 into q minus 1, by doing this means whatever the prime number we have chosen p and q, we are just subtracting 1 and 1 from both and finding out the multiplication, and that will be the number what we was means choosing a small odd integer. So after doing that, we are going to compute the d as the multiplicative inverse of e on modulo n, guarantees that d exists and is uniquely defined. So once we compute that e modulo n, that that will have means that is giving surety like that is that the finded number will be unique. Then publish the pair p d as the participant r as a public key, and that p the pair of p and d as we have seen earlier in the previous slide, like we are sending this the pair m and this row as pair of this public key. So that m and row will be finded as here we are sending that m and row as p and d as the participants are as a public key. Then we are keeping the secret key pair s and d as the participants are as a secret key. To encrypt a message m, the sender obtains the public key of recipient ku, that is e and n, that is a combination of that one. Just now we have calculated the e and we are taking n and compute c equal to me mod n, where we have where definitely means we should have that value of m that should be in between 0 or n. So how we are just now we have seen like how we are going to calculate the e, and then we have already having m, so we are just multiplying with m and e and finding the modulus of modulus with n, and that will be we will have the c, that is the encrypted ciphertext for that c stand for ciphertext. So just we are finding the ciphertext for the message, and that will be means transmitted through the channel. So once it has been transmitted, you know, once it has it is reached to the receiver end, so for decrypting it the ciphertext ciphertext C, the owner uses their private key KR, that is of the combination of D P Q. So just now see in the previous here we have the means we have the calculated D as that the multiplicative inverse of e modulo n. So that d and pq are the two prime numbers that we have chosen, that is two means large prime numbers that we have chosen. So using this, we are going to compute that m, that is m stands for message, that m equal to, just now we have computed ciphertext that c and c d and the modulo with the n, that will give me the message at the receiver end that will be decrypted. That as for the note that the message must be the smaller than the modulus, means that we are taking this as a size, that that message need to be smaller than this n. So for example we can say that how means we can take an example to understand this how it is working. So first we have for example purpose we have chosen that p and q as 17 and 11, this is two smaller, but for in that real time when we will use to this RSA algorithm for the encryption, we are choosing very large means large prime numbers. So for computing n, we are just multiplying with that p and q, and that 17 into 11 it will give that 187. So now we are computing that e, just in we have seen here e how to compute. So just we are finding that p minus 1 into q minus 1, so p that is 16 into 10, and it will give the value is 160. Now we are selecting that e as GCD of e 160 is equal to 1, that and choose E equal to 7. So after that we are determining D, and how we are going to calculate is like we have one here means expression that DE is equal to 1 mod 160, like we have seen here in this space, like how we are going to calculate D, that is the inverse or multiplicative inverse of E modulo N. So just it is multiplicative inverse means DE is equal to 1 mod that N we have that we have calculated phi N, and that must be lesser than 160, so we have chosen N as 160, and the value is D is equal to 23. And after that we are going to publish the key, that is 7 and 7 here E, the pair of this 7 and this 187 is this N. So that will be a public key which is published over the network, and we will keep the secret key, secret private key as 23, 17 and 11, that D is just we have calculated D, P and Q will be our the secret key, that is 23, 17 and 11. So simple RSA algorithm encryption decryption is like given message N equal to 88. So NB will be 88 will be lesser than 187. So encryption C equal to 887 mode 187. So we will have 11, and decryption will have means C will ciphertext will be 11, and when the will go for decryption, message will be recovered from this like 1123 by the mode 187. That will give 88, so the decrypted message is 88. Hence we have got that message, decrypted message as the as we have sent. So RSA key generation, that has means users of RSA must determine two primes. Just we have spoke about that, the procedures how we are going to do, like we should have our two random prime numbers PQ, and we are going to choose one by E. And we then based on that we are going to find the value of D and compute others. And then primes PQ must not be the easily derived from the modulos like N equal to PQ, P dot Q. Means must be sufficiently large, and typically guess the use guess and use probabilistic test. So exponents E, D are inverse, so use inverse algorithm to compute the other. So the three approaches for to attacking RSA is like brute force key search, that is infeasible given size of numbers, and the mathematical attacks based on the difficulty of computing phi of n by factoring modulus n, and timing attacks on the running of decryptions. So hence we have completed that RSA algorithm. So if we have any queries, we can deal with that. So.